Friends, welcome to GYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and we have started multiple MCQ series of different topics, so that when your prelims is near, you can be very much confident about the exam. So we are on this channel, we have started multiple MCQ series like of different topics like environment and ecology, modern India, ancient India, medieval India. So today we are going to start the first lecture of this medieval India series of MCQ. So friends, we will continue this series till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So in a way, daily 5 questions will be covered, and if you go by calculation, then approximately 1100 to 1200 questions of only medieval India will be covered. So you can imagine that how much confident you can be while attempting this topic in your exam, in your prelims exam. So friends, as you know that it is not the only topic that we are covering other series as well. So you can be very much confident in other topics as well if you are following us daily in those series, in those series as well. So let's start our discussion of today, the lecture number 1 of medieval India. The first question is related to Zabti or Bandobast system during the reign of Akbar is related to. So friends, first of all, please note this, that the Bandobast system was introduced during the reign of Akbar. When the Akbar was in power, then the Zabti or Bandobast system was introduced. So it was related to the land revenue system, an accession of enemy territories, see the Mansubdari system, the welfare of travelers. So friends, please note, the Zabti or Bandobast system, it was related to land revenue system. It was basically developed by Todarmal. You might have heard about the Todarmal. So basically, land revenue system of Akbar was called Zabti or Bandobast system. This was improved by the Raja Todarmal, and it was also known as Dhashala system, in which what was done, the Todarmal, what he introduced a uniform system of land measurement. So he introduced the system of land measurement which was uniform, and the revenue was fixed on the average yield of land assessed on the basis of past 10 years. So the land was also divided into 4 categories, that is palaj, that was cultivated every year, the prothi, that was cultivated once in 2 years, the chachar, that was cultivated once in 3 or 4 years, and the banjar, that was cultivated once in 5 or more years. So the payment of revenue was made generally in cash. So please note this, this is an important fact, these are important facts. Now let's move to the second question. The second question is, the Battle of Tarain is related to. The Battle of Tarain is related to the options given here: the Hindu princes of North India fighting against Muhammad Ghori. The B is the battle between Marathas and Rajputs. The C option is revolt in Gujarati kingdom against Mahmud of Ghazni. The D option is land battles in Sindh between Muslim provinces. So friends, let me tell you that Battle of Tarain is basically a dispute between the Hindu princes of North India and the Muhammad Ghori. So you might have heard about Prithviraj Chauhan. He fought 2 battles of Tarain with the Muhammad Ghori. In first battle of Tarain in 1191, he defeated the Muhammad Ghori. But in 1192, the Muhammad Ghori came with full preparation and completely defeated the Rajputs. And Prithviraj Chauhan was captured and he was killed. So after that, the political prestige of Rajput suffered a serious setback. So the whole Chauhan kind of Chauhan kingdom, Chauhan dynasty, it was under the control of Muhammad Ghori now, and the first Muslim kingdom was thus firmly established in India at Ajmer, and it totally changed it was kind of a watershed development in the history of India, as the first Muslim kingdom was established, that is Delhi Sultanate. Now the third question is related to Firoz Shah Tughlaq. We have to consider certain statements regarding Firoz Tughlaq. So first statement is, he strictly followed the advice of ulemas in running the administration. The second is, the ikta system was made hereditary. The third is, he was the first sultan to impose irrigation tax. So if you carefully observe, friends, these statements, then all these statements are correct. Firoz Shah Tughlaq, he strictly followed the advice of ulemas. Ulemas were basically religious leaders of Islam. So earlier, in the earlier periods of different sultans, the ulemas were not given much attention. For example, Alauddin Khilji or Balban did not pay much attention to the ulemas advice. But Firoz Shah Tughlaq listened to much extent these ulemas, and he also made the ikta system hereditary. So basically, Delhi Sultanate was divided into different provinces, and those provinces were called iktas, and those iktas were transferable. That means the one who was holding that ikta, it was not necessary that his son will also that same province. So it was transferable. So it was at the will of the sultan to whom the ikta will go. But the Firoz Shah Tughlaq made the ikta system hereditary. In a way, he patronized the nobles. He tried to please the nobles, and he was also the first sultan to impose irrigation tax. So it is an important fact that he was also the first sultan to impose irrigation tax. This can be asked in your prelims exam. So all the statements are correct. That is, D statement is correct. 1, 2, 3. So here is explanation. He was more notable for his administration. Ulemas contributed a lot to in his administration, and he tried to please the nobles and made the iktas hereditary. And Islamic law, he also followed Islamic law and levied taxes. Jizya, that was a tax on non-Muslims, it was imposed. And he was also the first sultan to impose irrigation tax. But at the same time, he dug irrigation canals and wells for the better irrigation of land. Next comes the fourth question under the Delhi Sultanate, Muktis or Walis were. Now, we have been asked who were the Muktis or Walis. So basically, friends, as I have earlier told you that in Delhi Sultanate, there were different provinces and they were divided into iktas, and these iktas were transferable. And the one who was holding that ikta was called iktadar. So his other names were Muktis or Walis. So basically, what were the function of these Muktis or Walis? Let's see. The A option is maintenance of law and order and collection of land revenue. The B option is managed financial accounts of central treasury. C is led mercenary military units in special warfare. The D is administered village assemblies. So for friends, the duty of the Muktis or the Walis was the maintenance of law and order and collection of land revenue. So a governor of a province or a Mukti of a province, or we can say the iktadar of a particular ikta, he had the responsibility of maintaining law and order in that particular ikta, as well as collection of revenue in that particular ikta. So this is all about your fourth question. So you can see it in detail in this description, which I will provide you in the PDF form. Now next question is, and the last question is about a king, about a sultan. So we have to judge that sultan. See, he paid the salaries in cash to the soldiers and also made price regulations called market reforms. And he was also the first sultan to measure the land. So his land revenue reforms were later also followed by Sher Shah Suri and Akbar. And who was that sultan? He was Alauddin Khilji. So Alauddin Khilji was famous for his land reforms as well as market reforms. So friends, A option is correct. So he divided the market in Delhi into four parts. The one market was for grain, another for cloth, sugar and dried fruits, butter and oil, and third was for horses, slaves, cattle, and fourth was for miscellaneous commodities. So each market was under the control of an officer called Shahanai Mandi. So the supply of grain was ensured by holding stocks in government storehouses, and regulations were issued to fix the price of all commodities. So these were his market reforms. So he maintained a strict control on the markets, and he tried to control the prices of various commodities. Because friends, let me tell you why the reason was so. Because he was facing the threat of a Mongol invasion. So for that purpose, he needed the large army. So if you have to maintain large army, then you also have to pay that army. So the treasury was not so much strong to sustain such number of large armies. So that's why he decided to keep the salary of the soldiers low. So and also try to control the market so that these soldiers are able to kind of sustain themselves and their families with such low salary. So he controlled the prices and also divided the market into four parts, and also each officer was installed in each mandi called, and he was called Shahnameh Mandi. So also he introduced land reforms. Let me tell you that he was the first sultan who measured the land, and he introduced land tax, and even the large big landlords were not spared from this land tax. So he paid soldiers in the cash, and his land revenue reforms provided the basis for the future reforms of Sher Shah and Akbar. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture of medieval India. So if you liked it, please share it with your friends, please like it, and if you like my videos, then please subscribe to my channel, and please click on the bell icon so that you can get the latest notifications of various uploads that we do on this channel. So lastly, friends, if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. So friends, daily we are covering 5 questions, and this will be covered till 31st May. So in a way, you can see that we will cover them till 2nd June. So if you go by calculation, then 1100 questions will be covered. So subscription fee for friends, it is kept rupees 100, just for the purpose of our motivation as well as for the purpose of your affordability. So you will just have to pay rupees 100 for the entire medieval India course. That means you will be getting 1100 to 1200 questions in just rupees 100. And friends, let me tell you that there are other courses as well, like ancient India, modern India, environment, for which subscription fees is different. So if you want to subscribe to them, then you will be offered discount also if you want to subscribe to them in package form. So lastly, friends, this is a slide I have included to tell you the various initiatives that we are running on this YouTube channel. That is, we have environment and ecology MCQ series, which costs you rupees 50, and ancient India MCQ series, which the charges of which we have kept rupees 100, and the medieval India MCQ series, which is also of rupees 100, and the modern India MCQ series, which is also of rupees 100. So total cost amounts to rupees 350. So if you want to subscribe to all these MCQ series in a package form, then we are offering you a discount of rupees 75. That means you will be getting all these PDFs in rupees 275. So for subscribing to the PDFs of these lectures, you can WhatsApp us at this number. So friends, why it is important to subscribe to the PDFs? Because at the end of the day, in the last minute, you can't see long videos, because at that time you will have to revise multiple topics. So you can't see 20 to 25 minute long video, and because it will be an utter wastage of time. So in order to conserve your time and to be confident in your exam, you must have some kind of notes to revise the basic concepts and to go in the exam and attempt it in confident manner. So if you want to subscribe the PDFs, then you can WhatsApp us at this number. Lastly, friends, let me tell you that we have a Telegram channel also, the link of which I will provide in the description box, and you can go to the description box and you can click that link, and you can join our Telegram channel by downloading this app, that is eSandesh, that is available on App Store as well as on Google Play Store. So basically what you have to do is, here is a search box shown, and you have to basically copy and paste my channel link here, and you will get to my channel. Friends, let me tell you that there is no cost of joining that channel. It is totally free of cost, and also there is no cost of this app. It is free of cost. So you can join it so that you can stay tuned with us and all other initiatives of ours. Thank you.